Hello, this is Solar Business TV from Anaheim, from Solar Power International 2018. And also, you know, from Beverly Hills, where we had 2 days ago, amazing gala and also brainstorm. And we are together with Mary O'Donnell, founder of Clean Power Inc. and also chairwoman of Empowering Women Initiative. And we always say Solar Mama of the Initiative. Hello, Mary.
Hello, Thomas.
So, Mary, first question, how did you enjoy the gala, but also, more importantly, how did you enjoy our brainstorm?
The gala was really beautiful because, of course, it's such a famous, old, beautiful hotel. But the brainstorm, I thought, was really, really good. And I thought that Gabby Sommerfeld came up with some very important things about battery and about how clean batteries need to be and that we have some work to do and that we should focus on what are our weaknesses, because that's important. We can all look at our successes, but we really have to look at what's next and what are we doing that we can do better. So, and that gentleman you introduced me to is really smart, who says he can fix all the battery problems. I really want to watch that guy. What was his name?
Don Sugar from Next Truck.
Yeah. I think we need lots of people like that to solve our problems, because it's not like we are perfect and that we don't have problems. But we can fix them. We've come this far. We've come a long way, baby, as they say. You just keep going.
Okay, so we'll speak about empowering women a bit later, yes? Because we also will have in our interview Alisa from Recon Solar, who is also joining the initiative. But I would like to speak about business now, yes? So you were in São Paulo, yes, a few days ago with us, and now you are in Anaheim. Also, you were following other activities in Shanghai, etc., and the world. So, how do you see, you know, the prospects for the solar business and also wind? Yes, because you are together in both businesses. Yeah? How do you see the prospects and what is still missing on the market?
The prospects are wonderful, and we just keep growing and getting better. And I think that one thing that we really have is we have 100%. People, mom and pop support. Everybody wants clean power. We've been poisoning people's children for 100 years now with fossil fuel. Everybody gets it. So yes, we are all of us at the right place at the right time with complete support from people, from the average mother and father who really know that sustainable energy is the really only way to go. Mm-hmm. Fossil fuel is dead. Fine, great, let's stop fracking, let's stop poisoning the water. Now is the time.
So what is your business model in Clean Power Inc.?
My business model is to sell as much wind and solar and hydropower before I die. And I'm calling it old, so I gotta really get going.
No, you are not so old, my friend. No, but seriously, what is your, like, you know, geographical coverage, yes? And which are your best deals, I would say, that you have now?
Okay. Geographically, wherever you have a wind or solar project for sale, we want to help you with it. We want to get it financed. We want to make sure it gets built. So wherever you are, we're willing to go. But I think the low-hanging fruit right now is certainly Mexico, a big, strong market, a very advanced market, and the money is secure there. And Brazil is wide open, and there's a lot of so much possibilities for both wind and solar in Brazil. So I'd say right now it's Mexico and Brazil, but I also really like Vietnam.
Mm. And what about Africa? Because you brought, yeah, you know, Mansoor, our friend, yes, from Japan, but he's African, yes, and Mansoor will be working with us in Solar Business Club. And what about Africa? Because you were saying that you also have quite a great footprint in the continent.
Of course, Africa has tremendous possibilities, and we finally have gotten some very, very good developers who are really some ripe deals in some very strong economies. And of course, they come with World Bank guarantees. So yes, and there's so much need in Africa, and the market's there. So yes, thank you for reminding me. See, I told you it was old.
So Mary, last question about human to human, yes? So we decided that solar is not only business to business, business to customer, but it's human to human. And do you still believe in that?
more than ever, of course, I believe in that. And I believe in the people in solar business in of themselves. They're all people that care about the environment. They care about people. And, for example, I was in Brazil. I'm particularly have a passion for the Mother Teresa sisters and the work that they do for the poorest of the poor. And in every country that I go to, I've been able to find a very important person in the solar business there. You know, your friend Leonardo has promised to visit the sisters there and take care of them, which is so wonderful. And so my goal is wherever we go, whatever country we're in, is to visit the missionaries of charity and to help them. Because they appreciate so much, but they need it so much. And they truly, truly, when you see them and meet them, they're just not of this world. They're just such wonderful people. They get up at 4:30 in the morning to care and feed for the poorest of the poor. How can you not want to help them?
That's why I was saying that Mary is our solar mama.
Thank you, Tim.
So thank you, Mary. But we'll speak about afterwards about empowering women, because also Mary has a really business-focused mind, and she would like to transfer this business mind thinking to all the women around the world. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.